Satellite images of the North Carolina coastline reveal features in the landscape scientists cannot explain. The shapes are large and oval, or egg-shaped, and stretch for miles and miles.
They're everywhere, one after another after another. It's got to be the biggest mystery in all of American geology.
George Howard is investigating the mysterious structures, nicknamed the Carolina Bays.
These are amazing features. I don't know what they are. They're low and flat and circled with a white bay rim. It's absolutely amazing.
Recent satellite images have only added to the mystery. These things are present in huge numbers.
People think that there might be 500,000 to 2 million of them.
Despite their nickname, the bays are not confined to North Carolina.
Strange enough to see them in one location, but what's crazy is when you zoom out, you can see that they extend from Florida all the way up the eastern seaboard to Delaware.
You can live on them. People's houses are all over them. Highways go through them. There's shopping centers around them.
George Howard is out searching for one of the shapes. It's more difficult than it looks.
This appears to be a white sandy rim here of a bay. It curves both sides to the left and to the right.
You can only see them when you're flying overhead, and that's when you get a real good look at this strange pattern on the ground.
George is using a drone to analyze the structure of the elliptical shapes.
To be able to get out here and actually use some of this amazing technology to fly basically robotic aerial cameras above Carolina Bays is really special.
Once airborne, the drone's camera helps to locate his position in the egg-shaped bay.
Wow, we are definitely where we thought we'd be. Looking at the photography, I think we're right on it right now. We can see the interior choked with vegetation in here and just a beautiful, brilliant white sand defining the western edge of the bay.
It's not just the existence of these egg shapes that baffles scientists. It's also the strange alignment.
What's so crazy about this is that they're all stretched in the same way. So it looks like someone took all these circles and just kind of dragged them so that they're all slanted in one particular way.
What's odd about this, what's really bizarre, is how do you get ovals in the same shape and in the same orientation? It's really strange.
Some experts think a clue may lie in the age of the bays. These shapes were created during the last ice age, thousands of years ago.
It's a time when North America was a very different place. It's a time when ice sheets were creeping down from the north, upwards of 10,000 feet thick. Ice sheets that are equivalent to what we would find today in Antarctica.
In this strange world of ice, prehistoric humans lived alongside many creatures that have long since disappeared from the Earth.
Right before the end of the Ice Age, there were amazing mammals that walked through this very area. Mastodons, mammoths, saber-toothed tigers, beavers the size of VW bugs.
Some scientists speculate if these enormous egg shapes are the work of giant beavers.
These beavers were like no beavers we have today. They were massive, probably had incisors 6 to 12 inches long, just a whole nother scale of beaver, and not something you would want to run into out here today.
But even giant beavers would have difficulty building dams on this scale.
I'm kind of amazed that the animals are capable of building such uniform structures, all in the same orientation. Are they all talking to each other? It would take a lot of giant beavers to make this many structures. Where are all their bones?
Instead of beavers, some scientists have linked the egg shapes to a terrifying ice age apocalypse.
One theory about the Carolina Bays is that some kind of an impact hit the ice sheet and actually blew chunks of ice down into lower latitudes.
Giant ice bombs, the size of massive icebergs, crashing down from the skies. The thought is as terrifying as it is bizarre.
You can only imagine if icebergs were launched hundreds of miles from the glacial ice sheet at hypersonic speeds, they would have landed in this landscape and exploded with the force of many, many atomic bombs.
But how could supermassive ice bombs have created the pattern we see today?
Maybe this is what happened. If you were standing here during this event, there would have been absolutely nothing you could have done. You could run a mile in any direction and you'd be still walking your way into apocalypse. The animals would have been wiped out.
But not everyone accepts the giant ice bomb theory.
There's nothing that big that's going to hit a sheet of ice and send giant ice cubes soaring through the sky to land on the ground hundreds of miles away to form an impact crater. It just doesn't work.
Scientists are still unable to explain these images. We don't know why these shapes are here, why they're this shape, why they are aligned in this strange way. We don't know what or who made them.
It's just so fascinating that there are still things on Earth, even something as abundant and widespread as this, that we just don't have an answer to.
A weather satellite captures an image of a deadly hurricane heading straight for the U.S. coastline.
It's like a freight train that's plowing through Haiti, and it is headed straight for Florida.
But there's something especially weird and scary about this storm.
The first time I saw this image, I thought it was Photoshopped. Somebody was making a joke.
October 4th, 2016. Hurricane Matthew batters the Caribbean island of Haiti.
It starts getting over warmer and warmer water and gathering more and more energy, doing massive amounts of destruction.
This is Matthew! Pray for us!
Was the strongest storm in 50 years to hit the country. The damage and destruction and loss of life is almost uncomprehendable.
When it's pointed at the hellstorm, the GOES-13 satellite captures this disturbing image.
It looks just like a skull. This demonic-looking, evil face with the eye of the storm just as it's hitting the shore.
It looks like something straight out of the Day of the Dead celebration.
The skull is captured by an infrared camera that allows experts to analyze and track the intensity of the storm's raging winds.
As it turns out, this is really how the storm looked as it was making landfall in Haiti.
But the skull isn't stopping at Haiti. It's heading straight for the United States. Weather experts are closely monitoring the storm as it approaches.
You're almost looking image by image every 10 or 15 minutes as the images update to see what's going on.
They spot something weird.
We're getting unusual radar reflections from the calm eye of the storm.
We see some kind of radar signature. Something is inside of that eye that shouldn't be there.
Each color in the image represents the density of the material inside the storm. Darker shades indicate calmness, while violent activity is red or orange.
You're expecting just to see darkness in the center of the hurricane. There shouldn't be anything there, but it's glowing green.
This gives the experts monitoring the storm a vital clue.
When we watch a radar image like this and we see this kind of reading, we then can conclude that it has to be something alive.
Whatever is inside the eye is a living, breathing creature.
As if a hurricane weren't scary enough, right? We've got something that might be alive and is really big inside of it.
It blows my mind that this is possible.
What huge creature could be dragged along by the mammoth hurricane? And how did it get there?
Maybe the hurricane has whipped up the water so much that it's actually sucked things out of it and into the sky.
There is a rare meteorological phenomenon that does vacuum up creatures from the ocean. It's known as a waterspout.
Waterspouts are basically tornadoes over the water.
And sure enough, there seems to be a rare waterspout attached to the skull.
Hurricane Matthew is passing the coast of Jamaica, and there are surfers on the beach as it's going by. They take photos and they find a water spout that's sucking things up right into the hurricane.
Those tornadoes or water spouts could actually lift frogs or fish up into the air, and those could show up on weather radar.